Hello students, in this lecture we will study about the next part of work energy power, that is power. Power is the rate of doing work or consuming energy. In other words, you can say that power is the rate of conversion of one form of energy into another form of energy. Average power is the work done divided by the total time taken, or you can say that the energy consumed over the time taken. The shorter is the time taken by a person or a machine in performing a particular task, the larger is the power of that person or machine. Power is a scalar quantity because it is the ratio of two scalar quantities, work done and time. The dimensions for the power will be the dimension of work done, that is ML2T-2 divided by the dimensions of time, that is T. So ultimately the power has dimensions ML2T-3. The instantaneous power is defined as the limiting value of average power as the time interval approaches to zero. Mathematically, instantaneous power will be the limit delta t tends to 0, P average. And by putting the value of average power in the terms of delta W by delta t, it will change into the first derivative of the work done with respect to time. By putting the value of work done, that is F dot S, force dot displacement, you will get F dot because the force is constant and the distance is changing. So ds by dt, and ultimately the instantaneous power will be equals to F dot V. That shows that the power is also a dot product of two vector quantities, and hence it is a scalar quantity. Some more points about power. The SI unit of power is watt. The power of an agent is said to be 1 watt if it does work at the rate of 1 joule per second. The bigger unit of power are kilowatt and horsepower. 1 kilowatt is the 1000 watt and 1 horsepower is 746 watts. 1 megawatt is 10 is to power 6 watt. Commercial unit of energy. Kilowatt hour or board of trade unit is the commercial unit of electrical energy. 1 kilowatt hour is the electrical energy consumed by an appliance of 1000 watt in 1 hour. And the relation between 1 kilowatt hour and joule is 3.6 into 10 is to power 6 joule. Efficiency is the ratio of output power to the input power. Or in the terms of energy, it will be the ratio of output energy to the input energy, and similarly for work. And if you have to calculate the percentage efficiency in numerical problems, then the symbol for this one will be eta, and it will be multiplied by the efficiency obtained into 100. Numerical problem of your NCERT, example 6.11. An elevator can carry a maximum load of 1800 kilogram, is moving up with a constant speed of 2 meter per second and the frictional force is 4000 newton, you have to determine the minimum power delivered by motor to the elevator in watts as well as in horsepower. By applying Newton's second law, we can calculate the net force, and that will be equals to mg plus the frictional force here, and that will be the 22,000 newton. So the motor must supply enough power to balance this force, and the power will be equals to F dot V, means 22,000 into 2 meter per second, and you will got 44,000 watt, and in terms of horsepower it will be 59 horsepowers. Thank you.